Micro-core beings got to do with Canada, a journey on the global sociological imagination plane. I was barely 5 years when my auntie borrowed me to live with her in the village of Tieria in a remote part of the eastern region of Ghana. As a child growing up in the village, I planted a great deal of cocoa seeds and seedlings. At the age of 8, I was already growing cocoa seeds on my auntie and uncle's farms. Cocoa seed planting was my part of the division of labor on the farm. And I did this for more than 10 years. So what, you ask? This little slice of my life story will vividly illustrate the process, logic, and dynamics of the subject matter of this course. It will also offer you a lucid lesson in the global sociological imagination. The global sociological imagination is based on the assumption that our individual biographies are not written or created by us alone as individuals, but are also the collective products, actions and indeed inactions of legions of people, many of whom live in far-flung corners of our global landscape and whose paths may never cross ours in our lifetime. The global sociological imagination is an extension of American sociologist Charles Wright Mill's sociological imagination, which posits a link between personal biographies and societal histories. Private problems and public issues. The present with the past. Having the global sociological imagination enables us to develop a keen awareness of the fact that our actions, seemingly inconsequential, do have ramifications, rippling far beyond our immediate environments and our shores. Think about it. Have you eaten chocolate or had a cup of cocoa drink or hot chocolate of late? If you have, chances are that the chocolate bar you ate or the cocoa drink you had contained beans from the cocoa trees I planted some 30 years ago interior, also known as Uwiafi Sunrise Village. Canada imports cocoa beans and cocoa products from various countries, including Ghana. Thus, the cocoa seeds I planted as a child is today providing nourishment to you and hundreds of thousands of your compatriots, and employment to even more Canadians who work in the chocolate and other chocolate-related industries. That is not all. All my education, from high school to graduate school, was paid for by people I call my unsung heroes and heroines in villages and cottages across Ghana. Money set aside by cocoa farmers in Ghana in the form of the Ghana Cocoa Marketing Board Scholarship Scheme financed my education. And here I am today, a professor in Canada, helping in my own small way to educate the future leaders of this country, my newfound home. But my being here in Canada would not have been possible without Canadians purchasing cocoa products, chocolate bars, cocoa drinks, etc. Canadian Communication Studies scholar and social philosopher Marshall McLuhan put us all in the global village, where willy-nilly, for better or for worse, we inhabitants are increasingly becoming interconnected, integrated, intermixed, intermingled, and interdependent. Whatever happens at one corner of the village affects all of us almost instantaneously. It is my hope that this course will ignite your own global sociological imagination so you can properly see your place in the tangled web of the global scheme of things. Know what role you can play in making our global village better, keeping in mind that your actions and inactions affect all members of the village. For as Martin Luther King Jr. put it so beautifully, we are all caught in an inescapable network of mutuality, tied in a single garment of destiny.
Yo alo adu jam to Burundi, yo alo adu jam to Kazamas, la ul minjona he. Africa.